should free Crimea, as Russia should free Crimea, and Ukraine will sign any type of peace document to calm Russian security threat. Russia is afraid of NATO, will be at their doorstep, and a threat, so basically it's insecurity that they're dealing with. Although Ukraine will maintain peace and will not allow any foreign military bases to Ukraine. Harm is Crimea, and Ukraine is in turmoil under Russian control. First harm is the economy, their economy is suffering from this. Ukraine fed water to Crimea, and that's cost $80 million each season of harvest season due to agriculture, which is a vital part of their economy. And then the national disarray is another point where their citizens within Crimea are not seen eye to eye. 20% of their citizens are Russian, so they have a lot of turmoil within their citizenship. And then three is underwater affects agriculture. Inherently, no one has done anything to step in. Our plan is Russia should free Crimea and Ukraine to use Russia liberation of Crimea. Plan. And Russia leaves Crimea through natural means. Solvency is Crimea gains liberation and peace and economic influx through agriculture and business. These advantages will Russia gains better public opinion and Crimea gains independence.
Know your law, because there's a disadvantage with the gas pipeline that have been shut down before. If Russia feels threatened, they'll shut off the gases. Therefore, people will die during the winter, and 85% of the people use natural gas. Another disadvantage would be the proxy wars, which creates violence which if we get involved, it'll create violence where we shouldn't be involved in. The impact will be to prevent another war that's unnecessary. Crimea's water supply got cut by the Ukrainian government due to the amount of debt Crimea owes to Ukraine. Ukraine will not remain peace because Crimea owes them money. Therefore, they will not sign any peacemaking contracts or they're not seeing eye to eye for a reason. And the affected agriculture is because Russia is refusing to repay the amount of debt they owe. Crimea will not gain independence because that will cost more than it should.
I have a question. Do you guys define this house as the U.S.?
Yes.
Okay. As the water canals are stopped, this is worsening tensions between Ukraine and Russia, which can potentially lead to resource wars, which can result in bitter on both sides and struggling for resources. ultimately creating a war. So nobody has intervened to help solve this crisis. It is essential that a superpower intervene to help mediate tensions and ultimately resolve the crisis, so that things return back to normal and the war doesn't break out and make matters worse to handle. The plan, the U.S. should act as an agent to help make this happen, as they're a country with a lot of power and resources. They can help mediate tensions and at least intervene. These tensions will not solve themselves between Russia and the Ukraine. To help, this will indicate to Russia and Ukraine that the problem needs to be fixed. Then they will work towards establishing a plan that works towards remedying the situation. A compromise will be reached and both powers will work out an agreement. If necessary, the U.S. will assist in establishing a compromise. If the problem isn't fixed within Russia, between Russia and Ukraine, it's only going to get worse. And I believe the third party is necessary to help remedy the situation, as they are unbiased in their opinion, and they are working towards helping both Russia and Ukraine establish a compromise where they can both benefit from it equally and not have a bias towards one country or the other. Crimea has received 85% of fresh water from the canals built in 1961 to 1971, and due to the stoppage of water, this can potentially lead to crop issues, which will ultimately impact the inhabitants' resources. This is Ukraine's form of protest, and it needs to be resolved because it is impacting their economy and the lives of those who live in Crimea.
And then it's both of us, and then...
It's... you, and then Vivian for a 2-minute rebuttal, and then Bryant, 2 minutes.
Okay. You mentioned that the U.S. has to step in as a third party between Russia and Ukraine. And you also said something about them establishing a plan. Your plan really wasn't really clear. You mentioned there was a plan, but you didn't mention what you were going to do. U.S. clearly should not get involved, because as we mentioned before, as Vivian mentioned before, this can cause a war outbreak with Russia. I mean, we already said that the G7 is already taking part in this situation with... the G7 consisting of seven countries. They promote peace and they fix these issues in a peaceful manner without any violence. So having the U.S. getting involved clearly is not a good idea. It's the same thing. They can create a war that we should not be involved in problems that are not reflecting on us, for the same reason that we need to worry about our own problems we have here. And you said that Crimea is receiving 85% of their water from the canals, right? So this impacts their economy. I mean, Crimea has their own. Okay, so we don't see how the U.S. would help really in their water system. So you said that debt would be on both sides. Well, if we're gonna financially support Ukraine, I mean, we're not in the best situation ourselves. So that would put us in an even bigger debt we have on our own.
which would definitely not help or solve this problem.
Russia is already planning to build pipelines through Russia's southern region. Another plan is drilling wells and using water as reservoirs. And Crimea is already redrawing the map of crop areas in the region where the crops are, agriculture may not be available. Crimea's water supply is about 7% unusable, so it'd be less burdensome for Ukraine to do it if Ukraine were to pass Crimea to Russia. So the U.S. should not. The U.S. should not interfere because Ukraine and Russian officials are already coming to an initial conversion between both sides. And they both have their own. They're asking eye to eye because of applications of the Revolution. And the G7 are already taking action. And this is why our plan is better.
US can act as a force to help establish compromise. The G7 has not done anything to solve anything that's going on so far. So thus, U.S. should get involved, and we do it through peaceful means. There's no need for war.
You said that, Lee said that U.S. involvement is not a good idea because we would essentially be creating a war that we do not need to get involved with, and we need to worry about our own problems. But you see, if the problem between Ukraine and Russia is not solved, and they're working towards solving it right now, they clearly haven't solved it. And through time, it can potentially get worse. And eventually, if it isn't solved, then this could potentially lead to us having to get involved and having to use forceful methods to help their situation, to help alleviate their situation. So in order to avoid something going downhill, so like something like this going downhill, you know, the tension between Russia and the Ukraine, we should act now as soon as possible and do it through peaceful means so that this doesn't escalate towards something worse that gets out of hand and that the United States is obliged to get involved with, and it could potentially lead to a war between all Ukraine, Russia, and the United States. You said we're not in the best situation ourselves, but we're not working towards spending a lot of money on resolving their situation. We're only acting as a mediator towards reaching a peaceful compromise where both Ukraine and Russia can get something out of it and not have to be in this tense situation. You said that the United States should not intervene because Ukraine and Russia have already have representatives working on that, but clearly nothing has been done and the situation is still persistent and it's still existing, so the United States should get involved. And we can work out a peaceful treaty. We don't necessarily have to resort to violent means. And if the situation isn't fixed now, it could potentially get worse and out of hand to where U.S. involvement is going to be necessary and possibly violent. And this is why the United States should get involved. And